بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم رب زدني علما صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم آمين الحمد لله رب العالمين. In this lecture, I will discuss the important concepts of evaluate without using calculator in trigonometry. For this lecture, I am using the work of one of my best student, Ms. Safa Idris of class 2020, the Lyceum. An important advice for me and for everyone, we should be soft to others. Evaluating without using calculator. Do not use calculator for the special angles. Special angles, 30 degree, 45 degrees and 60 degrees. These three angles are special angles. In radians, 30 degrees pi by 6 radians, 45 is pi by 4 and 60 is pi by 3 radians. For these angles, do not use calculator. Trigonometric ratios for special angles. The value of sine 30 is half, and the value of cos 60 is also half, and these two angles are complementary. If you know the value of sine 30, which is half, you can easily learn the value of sine 60, because this angle and this angle, they both are complementary. 90 minus 30 makes 60. Similarly, if you know the value of sine 60, which is root 3 upon 2, you don't need to learn the value of cos 30. 90 minus 60 makes 30, so the value of cos 30 is root 3 upon 2. You have option, either you should learn the values of sine and cos, or you just learn the values of sine, and you can easily make the values of cos with the help of the values of sine. Anyway, sine 45 is equal to cos 45, and both are equal to 1 upon root 2. Make sure you write 1 upon under root 2. You must not write under root 2 upon 2, because this is the simplified form of this, and this is not acceptable. The examiner expects that you would not use the calculator to evaluate the values of the special angles. So this is without using calculator, and this is with the use of calculator. So this value is not acceptable for the examiner. Make sure you write this value. Sine 60 is equal to cos 30, and both are under root 3 upon 2. Tan 30 is 1 upon root 3, tan 60 is root 3, tan 45 is 1. Make sure you write 1 upon root 3. You must not write root 3 upon 3, because this value is from calculator, and this is unacceptable for the examiner. Make sure you learn these values by heart. Quadrants. Use cos to remember quadrants. You know, this means all positive. A means all positive. In first quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive. Sine, cos, and tan, they all are positive. So A means all, and all means sine, tan, and cos. In second quadrant, S means only sine is positive and the rest are negative. In this quadrant, cos is negative, tan is negative. T means tan is positive and rest are negative. C means cos is positive and rest are negative. You can learn this as cast. C-A-S-T. Well, there are two directions. Anti-clockwise and clockwise. Anti-clockwise direction is for positive angles, and clockwise direction is for negative angles. If the given domain is positive, then you have to work in anti-clockwise direction like this. If the given domain is negative like this, then you should work in clockwise direction. Till here, 90 degrees, 180, 270, and this is 360. When you will work in clockwise direction, till here minus 90, minus 180, minus 270, and minus 360. If there are two cycles, then this is 720. This is 90, 180, 270, 360, and second cycle 450, 540, and so on. first cycle -90, -180, -270, -360, -440, 450 and so on. Well, the names of the or numbers of the quadrants remains unchanged whether you work in anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction, first, second, third, fourth in both the directions. Basic angle alpha. Basic angle is denoted by alpha. The alpha's value is always positive because alpha is an acute angle. Alpha lies between 0 and 90 degrees. To find general angles, we use basic angle alpha. Alpha is always formed from the horizontal axis, from here. So make sure you learn these three things or remember these three things. Alpha is always positive because it is an acute angle, and we use alpha to find general angles, and alpha is always formed from the horizontal axis. Complementary angles relations. You need to learn these relations by heart. The sum of two angles is 90. This means complementary angles. For complementary angles, the sum of two angles must be 90, like 30 plus 60, like 10 plus 80. So sine pi by 2 minus theta is cos theta. This angle is here. Sine will become cos. We did this earlier in this lecture. Sine 30 is cos 60. See, the sum is 90. So these angles are complementary. So always write this answer here, this angle here. Cos will become sine for complementary angles, and this angle should be here. And tan will become 1 upon tan x. Pi by 2 means 90. You can also write this in this way. 90 minus theta is cos theta. This is in degrees and this is in radians. Supplementary angles. You don't need to learn the relations for supplementary angles. You just need to make the rough sketch and then you can write your answer. You just need to decide the signs of the trigonometric ratios, because for supplementary angles, sine will remain sine, cos will remain cos, tan will remain tan. So sine pi minus theta, first make the rough sketch. Theta is here. This means second quadrant. Pi minus theta is here. In second quadrant, sine is positive. So the answer of this is positive sine, this angle. Cos pi minus theta will become negative cos theta, because in second quadrant cos is negative. Tan pi minus theta will become minus tan theta, because in second quadrant tan is negative. See, function is same for supplementary angles, just change the sign of the functions according to the quadrant. Sine is positive, cos and tan both are negative. This is the application of this rule, supplementary angles relations. So if the question is find the value of sine 120 without using calculator, make the rough sketch, decide the quadrant, this is in second quadrant, so sine is positive, get the basic angle of this 120 with respect to quadrant, it is 60 degrees. So you should write sine 120 as sine 60 according to this formula, positive sine 60. And you know the value of sine 60, it's under root 3 upon 2. This is the way to evaluate this without using calculator. If the question is cos 120, then it should be minus cos 60. Basic angle should be here, and this is negative because of the quadrant. In second quadrant, cos is negative. And the answer of cos 60 is half. So because of this minus, the answer is minus half. You can also evaluate tan 120. So tan 120 will be negative tan 60, which is minus root 3. Use cos to decide the signs of trigonometrical ratio and also make a rough sketch. We did this here. We decided these signs according to this quadrant. Reflex angles relations. Reflex means angle lies between 180 and 360. When theta is in third quadrant, then this is the rough sketch. In third quadrant, tan is positive and rest are negative. So sine pi plus theta will become negative sine theta. This angle should be here. This is negative cos theta and this is positive tan theta, because in third quadrant tan is positive. This is also reflex angle, but the quadrant is fourth. In this quadrant only cos is positive. So sine 2 minus 2 pi minus theta will become minus sine theta. This will become negative tan theta and this will become positive cos theta. This angle is here because of this quadrant, cos is positive. Right angled triangles in all four quadrants. When x is acute, then triangle must be in first quadrant, because acute angle in first quadrant. So sin x will become sin alpha, cos x will become cos alpha, tan x will become tan alpha. All are positive because in first quadrant all are positive. This is a triangle in first quadrant. So if we know the value of sin x, let's suppose 4 upon 5, then we can get the value of adjacent. This is opposite, this is hypotenuse, and we can easily get the value of tan and cos. Cos will be 3 upon 5 and tan will be 4 upon 3. When x is obtuse, then triangle should be in second quadrant. This is obtuse angle. So sin x will become plus sin alpha, cos x will become negative cos alpha, because in second quadrant cos is negative and tan is also negative. This is the example of this case. Given sin x is this and x is obtuse, find tan x and cos x. First make the triangle. This is the triangle, this is here. This is opposite and this is hypotenuse. So mention these two here. And according to Pythagoras theorem, this is 3 adjacent. Now we need tan x. So tan x will be minus tan alpha. This rule is here. And tan alpha in this triangle is 4 upon 3. So the answer is minus 4 upon 3. But make sure you must write this thing first and then you write your answer. You should write your answer after this step. Cos x will be minus cos alpha according to this rule. And cos alpha in this triangle is 3 upon 5. So your answer is minus 3 upon 5. You have to write this equation and this equation first before writing your answers. When x is reflex and is in third quadrant, so triangle should be here and only tan will be positive and rest are negative. And you need to write alpha here, here and here. When x is reflex and is in fourth quadrant, then triangle must be in fourth quadrant and cos must be positive. Cos x will be cos alpha, sin x will be minus sin alpha, and tan x will be minus tan alpha. Given sin x is minus 3 upon 5 and x is in fourth quadrant, find cos alpha and tan x. So you can easily do this question. You just need to first draw the triangle in fourth quadrant. This is opposite and this is hypotenuse, 3 and 5. Don't take this sign negative. Just take the numerical values, because you are not making a constructing or drawing triangle for x, you are drawing the triangle for alpha. So just ignore this negative. This negative is just for the quadrant. So this 3 is here, this 5 is here, and according to Pythagoras theorem, this is 4. Now if you need cos x, then it should be cos alpha, positive cos alpha. And cos alpha in this triangle is 4 upon 5. And tan alpha in this triangle is 3 upon 4. So if you need tan x, you need to write minus tan alpha. This is here. And then you should write your answer. For known angles, use cos to decide the direction and choose the corresponding quadrant. See, number one, decide the direction. You need the value of sine minus 210 without using calculator. First, decide the direction with respect to the sine. So this means you have to work in clockwise direction. This is here. and the quadrant is second. In second quadrant, sine is positive. So this sine is decided by the quadrant, and this direction is decided by this sine. So you have to decide two things. Number one, decide the direction with the help of this sine of the angle, and then this sine should be decided by the help of the quadrant. This is with respect to quadrant, and this direction is with respect to the sine. So minus 210 means work in clockwise direction. You are in second quadrant. In second quadrant, sine is positive. So sine minus 210 must be sine 30. Write the basic angle here. And sine 30 is half. This is the way to find the value of this without using calculator. Always make the rough sketch. Minus 315. Minus means work in clockwise direction like this. Alpha 45. In first quadrant, all positive. So this will be cos 45, and this is the answer of cos 45. 1 upon root 2. Tan 405. You have to work in anti-clockwise direction. This is 360 till here, and this small part is 45. So this is 405. So basic angle is 45. So tan 405 should be tan 45, and the answer of tan 45 is 1. Tan 240. Anti-clockwise direction, third quadrant. So the basic angle is 60. In third quadrant, tan is positive. So this will be tan basic angle 60, which is root 3. We have to solve this, and this is the answer. So we need to use these things, like rough sketches. This is here. Let me explain this first here, and then I will show the solution. This is in second quadrant, tan 120. So this is 60. So this will be minus tan 60. So here you have to write minus tan 60. This is in third quadrant, 240. So this is negative, basic angle 60. So this should be minus sine 60. This is in fourth quadrant, negative 315, 45. So this should be negative tan 45. This is in third quadrant, 225. Basic angle is 45. So this should be positive tan 45. We have to first make the rough sketches, and then you can write these things. And after that, you just need to put the value of these things. You know the value of tan 60 is root 3. This is root 3 upon 2, this is 1, and this is also 1. Now, I show the solution of this. This is here. This is in second quadrant, so minus tan 60. This is in third quadrant, so minus sine 60. This is in fourth quadrant, so minus tan 45. This is in third quadrant, so tan 45. The value of tan 60 is under root 3. The value of sine 60 is root 3 upon 2. The value of tan 45 is 1, tan 45 is 1, and that's the final answer. Well, this is all. Inshallah, I will discuss solutions of trigonometric equations in my next lecture. Good luck, and Allah Hafiz.